Hey everybody, welcome back to my channel. Today I want to tell you about a new mask kit. As you know, most of the time the masks that you can only get in the store or at Sephora are already made for you. They come in a tube or they come in a jar, and pretty much what they tell you to do is all you can do with it. Well, with this kit that Source Vital sent me, and thank you so much, Source Vital, for allowing me this opportunity to share your newest product with everyone that watches my videos and everyone that I know. This kit allows you to put together your own mask or facial scrub. And so I'm going to go ahead and open the package to show you what it looks like. I've already opened it just to make sure that everything was there. And if I had to contact them about anything, I would have the opportunity and the time to do that before showing it to you. This is what it looks like. And it says, Renee's Make Your Own Mask Kit. And so I am so, so excited about this. But it says, this customized mask kit includes laminaria, seaweed powder, your facial infusion selection, and your selected additives. So let me show you what it looks like. It comes with the cards that tell you about the product and the things that you requested. And I will read those cards off to you in just a little bit. This is how it came. Beautiful, beautiful green. I love the color green anyway. But it just lets you know that what you're about to receive is just natural and good for you. And so these are all the items that were placed in the box. So we have some sponges. We have the activated charcoal, rose hip seed powder. I'm so excited, so excited. And then the oils. And so I'll tell you about those in a little bit. Plus a little bowl to mix everything in. And it has the stirring sticks. So, and all of this was on top of a bed of some green spaghetti paper. Just beautiful. And I want to let you know that this smelled so amazing when I first opened it up, and it still does. It smells so natural and so clean and so fresh. And it just lets me know that what I'm about to put together is going to be so good for my skin. And so I am very excited and can't wait to use this. So let me go ahead and read the cards to you. Okay, so when you order this, I'm saying when because I just have a feeling that you're going to want to try this for yourselves. But I'm going to give you a review. I'm going to show you how I use it, and I'm going to give you a review on how it feels when I apply it to my skin, how easy it is to mix, how my skin feels afterwards, and all of that. But the retail price for this is $44.95. It is pricey, but when you think about what you get to do, and the ingredients that are in it, it is well worth it. So, it has a step one, a step two, and a step three. So, step one is selecting your facial infusion. And this improves your skin's appearance with these blends. And so I chose oil control because I do have combination skin. I'm oily right here. I'm oily on my nose. So the little T-zone area is where I have the most, you know, problems with my skin. So oil control, T-zone, or combination skin, it balances oil production so that you're just not seeping oil all over the place. This is supposed to control that. Step two, make your own mask a scrub. So a mask and a scrub at the same time. In step two, you can add an exfoliant to your mask to simplify your routine. And so for when I make a scrub, I would use the rose hip seed powder. And it is a gentle exfoliation. And it's good for sensitive and aging skin. So I have both. I'm not getting any younger. I'm getting older. And so I also have sensitive skin. I can't use everything on my skin. My skin breaks out with certain things, but I want to tell you, you have a choice of what I got if you have sensitive skin and aging skin. You also could get jojoba seed powder, which is a medium exfoliation for all skin types. And you can do pumice, which is the most exfoliation for all skin types except sensitive. All right, in step three, you select your shots. And you can choose up to three for this. Add more oomph to your mask with these powerful additives. And what I chose was the activated charcoal. And activated charcoal is purifying. It reduces the appearance of pore size. So I always need that because in my oily areas, my pores seem to be more apparent. And so I would rather not be able to see my pores. The next thing that I chose is copaiba balsam. And I'm almost certain I'm not pronouncing that right, but copaiba balsam for skin lacking firmness and for scarred skin. So I struggle with the hyperpigmentation and I always look for anything that's going to help me with that. And I'm always trying to keep my skin nice and firm. I don't want it sagging. I don't want to show that I'm aging. You know, I want to keep that to myself. You know, it's not everybody's business. Anyway, Lavender Tansy Blend is for sensitive skin. It is a combination of lavender essential oil, lavender absolute oil, and blue tansy essential. So, I can't wait to put all of this on my face. And so I'm going to show you that in a bit. And so I have the directions here on how to put either the scrub together or the actual just mask together. And so I will do that in a little bit. So stay tuned. you all the details. The mask, first of all, when putting everything together and adding that hot water to the mask and stirring it, just the aroma. I mean, it was like having aroma therapy while making the mask. And as I applied the mask to my face, it had cooled down because you're using super hot water. You're using tea hot water, is what it says in the directions. And so when you're applying it to your face, or by the time you apply it to your face, it's just the perfect temperature and it feels so good. I mean, you're just relaxed. Putting something warm on your face, like when you put a warm towel on your face or you're washing your face with warm water, you know how that feels. So applying a warm mask that is the perfect temperature feels so, so good. And so I applied it to my face and that warmth just was incredible. And then leaving it on, once I removed it, I had minor irritation, and it says specifically do not put in the eye area. And I didn't realize at that time that I was putting it just a tad bit too close, so I had just a little breakout around here, but I hope that you can see the breakout is gone. It left within maybe about 10 or 15 minutes, and it didn't even itch. It was just like letting me know you put it just a little too close to the eye area. So you really have to be careful and follow those instructions. My skin felt soft, but at the same time, it was firm. Not tight to where you couldn't like talk like I'm talking now, but it feels so firm and just tight, like I'm younger than where I am. So it's super soft, super firm, but not too firm where you can't just, you know, move your mouth. But you see, I'm talking and I'm moving and I'm smiling and it's comfortable. But I couldn't believe that firmness was there. I mean, immediately after I washed it all off, that is what I felt. My skin, I feel, looks good. And I can't say anything negative about the mask. I really enjoyed it. Just the process of being able to make it myself, knowing what all the ingredients are, and putting it together, and the scent, and the way it felt when I put it on, and then the results after I took it off. I love it. I would recommend it to you all. What I would recommend, though, is know anything that you're allergic to. Don't ask for any ingredients that you know will irritate your skin, but also be sure that you know your skin needs so that you can ask for and request the ingredients that are going to help you the most within the mask. And that's really all I have to say. I hope that you all will give it a try. And if you have tried it already, then let me know your results. If you haven't and then you choose to try it, please let me know how you felt after you've tried the mask. Anyway, and also Source Vital would love to hear from you as well. Let them know what you think about it. And if you have any questions, you can always contact them and they will give you the information that you need and answer all your questions. There will be a part two to this mask. I will be doing the scrub portion of the mask for the next Friday facial. So if you're interested in seeing how I feel about the scrub part, then look forward to that because I will be doing that. I may not show the exact process, but I will show application of the mask, and then I will tell you about the results of that portion of the mask. But anyway, ask your questions below, give me your comments below what you think, and I'll see you all on the next video. God willing. Take care. Bye-bye. Don't forget to visit me on other forms of social media. Also, I have a lifestyle blog. You might want to check it out. www.glamourgourmet.com. Peace.